everyone. How are you? This is Korean Buddhism Lecture 8. It's Identity, Culture, and History by Korea Dharma Master, Venerable Wonung Bogum, Dr. Richiran. Is Korean Buddhism in decline? Over the past 10 years, the status and authority of Korean Buddhism has plummeted. It is being challenged by believers within Buddhism. In particular, they are calling for financial transparency. Currently, Korean society, or market economic system driven by neoliberalism, which greatly influences the economy. Believers who are accustomed to this situation are sensitive to the flow of temple economy, cannot ignore the fact that it is being used abnormally. In general, believers at temples are believers with economic power, middle class or higher citizens who live with some sense of the flow of Korean economy. In their eyes, the opacity of the employee economy would have been an unbearable and inconvenient economic operation. Another trend is how to view the Sangha. In particular, the behavior some Sangha has seen by Buddhist intellectuals would have been an ethical and moral issue that was difficult to ignore. It would have been impossible to just sit by and watch the other's self-purification ability, inspection function, which ignores even openly criminal act. In a situation where midnight was not established within the religious order itself, and pay reward and punishment were not imposed, such an illegal behavior from the perspective of a citizen under rule of law would have been subject of criticism. Another important point is the social law and function of Buddhism. The authority of Korea's representative mainstream religion is not in words. In particular, this is the stature and authority of Korean Buddhism as seen by Buddhist intellectuals. If you keep silent, you will worry about your identity as a lay Buddhist with pride as a Buddhist. A group of outside Buddhist intellectuals is speaking up. Out of a sense of self-destruction, questioning whether it is really possible for Buddhism to poke like this in Korea. On the other hand, intellectual groups within Buddhism are in a dilemma of not being able to speak out. First of all, because they are economically tied to Buddhism and Sangha. You are in a situation that it is too difficult to kick the bucket. So you have a thought, but there are limits to putting them into action. And you feel weak. However, we are in a position where there is no theory or justification to respond to voices of intellectuals outside of Buddhism. However, some intellectuals are using it as a survival strategy by repeating old-fashioned recordings and singing empty song and echoes of communism while spreading a listless logic. It was just a few years ago, regardless of whether it was a temple, a monk, a Buddhist, or member of another religion, it was a natural phenomenon for something to immediately spring up in one's mind emotionally as an icon of our traditional religious culture. When I went to a temple, regardless of whether I was a Buddhist or not, any Korean felt a sense of the origin of certain culture that was no different from the source of our national culture. For every temple and monk, there was a benefit of being respected in common and receiving donation in common. Even though it was not a temple I personally went to, and monks I did not know, we had a common feeling toward Korean Buddhism. Offering alms and respecting them without distinction, it was a religious phenomenon. Not long ago, this was the attitude toward Buddhism that took place in this country. Needless to say, who is causing the status of Buddhism to plummet drastically? There is a need to coolly analyze and gain insight. Who is destroying the image of Korean Buddhism as a whole? There is an urgent need to analyze the causes and draw some conclusions. Nevertheless, it feels like the forces capable of such critical analysis and insight have also collapsed. The group that is at the forefront of doing this work is the media. The media within the religious world has already reached a point of paralysis, and only a small number of media outlets are doing their best. Would it be too much of a prejudice to say that the conscience of a religious media is already paralyzed to the point that it is questionable whether there is really a force of conscience alive in Buddhist world? Moreover, the attitude of prevented study, sophistry of the religious intellectual group is also at the level of despair. When I see Buddhist intellectuals giving irrational support or acting ambiguously as if they are completely divided, I get a sad feeling that there is really no hope for our Buddhism. So now I am talking about Korean Buddhism, modern day Korean, some problem in Korean Buddhism. You know, now I am talking about my lecture near Jogesa Temple here. About even 10 years ago, 20 years ago, 30 years ago, there were many, many monks passing by. But this morning, I came to this studio. I couldn't see monks. This is a situation in Korean Buddhism. So anyway, thank you very much for listening. Thank you.